Well, we teach them not only in the introductory level, but we'll teach many of the same students in an upper level genetics course, an upper level evolution course, an upper level developmental biology course, an upper level microbiology course. We'll teach them again and again. So we have a chance to see what did they actually retain from the introductory genetics course, and what did they not retain, and what did, and how did this work? And so we've been able to see that and track it and try to build it from one thing to the next. So by trying to make it very intentional that we would focus on the connections between topics, and we would tell the students, we're focusing on the connections. A lot of the details are going to get added in other courses, but we're going to really focus to make sure you understand how these topics are connected to one another by putting the emphasis there, and then we can fill in details in other courses or in other ways, so we could actually see that this was working, that they were seeing the connections, which allowed them to fill in other information. Information is not in short supply right now. They can access information on their phones. So what they need is not information, they need information within the context of how to understand it in the broader context of the field. And what we're trying to do is teach the connections.
Now, one of the things we do at Haverford that's becoming a lot more common in undergraduate curricula is that we have an upper level discovery-based or inquiry-based lab course where students are taught to do research in a classroom setting. And there, it's really important that students have the fundamentals for the experiment they're going to do. But then they also need to bring in a wide variety of information and skills. And I think one of the things that our introductory course does quite well is to provide the foundation that will allow them to become researchers when they enter those sorts of classes.